Welcome to the GamingLife.com review of Mordhau. Mordhau is dubbed an online medieval slasher by its developers Triternian. The game features skill-based medieval combat, deep customization, and several types of online multiplayer modes. Frontline is a massive player versus player, capture the flag, tug-of-war battle with up to 64 players. It reminds me of the Battlefield franchise, but with medieval weapons. Team Deathmatch, a smaller player versus player mode based on kill count, can queue with up to 24 players. The first team to reach 1,000 points wins. Skirmish, another player versus player mode, last team, last man standing with only one death per match, and you can queue with up to 64 players. And yes, of course, because what game does not have a battle royale? Queue with up to 64 players, loot everything you can on the way, and be the last man standing to win. Mordhau also included a little something for the PvE folk. A horde mode with waves upon waves of medieval mobs trying to kill you and six of your friends. Upgrade your weapons and see how many waves you can last before you wipe. Please keep in mind, if you are joining a private server, rules and game sizes may vary. Before we dive into the gameplay, let's talk about character customization. I was really impressed with this from both the cosmetic and playstyle aspects. Everything down to your voice is cosmetically customizable. 9 gear slots total, only 3 of which offer in-combat stats, 4 customizable cosmetic slots per weapon, and of course all the fun stuff, hair, height, weight, etc. Playstyle and combat benefit customization begin with 16 talent points. 3 of your gear slots have armor stats. You can choose from either light, heavy, or medium armor. You also have 3 weapon slots you can equip with any type of weapon in the game. Melee, ranged, bombs, healing packs, and of course, a 4th, everyone has them, your fists. Weapons vary in 3 stat lines, damage, speed, and reach. Finally, you have perks. Perks can provide procs, buffs, and even added abilities like dodge. All equipped items or perks must amount to 16 talent points or less. Combat in Mordhau can be tilting at first, especially on maps with 64 players. Dodging ranged archer attacks, catapults, watching out for mounted enemies, getting hit by melee outside of your peripheral vision can be very frustrating. We tried to use an Xbox controller, but some of the buttons like sprint did not work at the time, even though we had them set up correctly in keybinds. Using a mouse requires you to swipe it in the direction you want to swing, along with a click. The same principle goes for blocking. We like the hitbox, however, it can be hard to judge at times depending on what terrain you're on. A hill, a downslope, an upslope. Some weapons have ridiculous range. Blocking is very difficult when only using a melee weapon. Your timing must be perfect. Shields, on the other hand, can be held up to block, but they are vulnerable to a kick, which will knock you back, leaving you open for an attack. Jukes are a thing. It's all about timing in combat. Your riposte, combos, blocking, and punishes. The skill cap for high-end play is through the roof. You're more than welcome to employ our strategy. We run around the field, flailing our two-hander, trying to hit people in the back while they're fighting someone else. No skill required. The game was built in Unreal Engine 4. The graphics are solid, it plays smooth, there's tons of gore and blood, heads, limbs getting chopped off, pulling arrows out of your body, blood everywhere. We were able to run Mordhau on ultra settings on a 7th gen i7 with a 1080 Ti. Triternian had a goal of making the game feel as real as possible. I think they lived up to it. The sound is a huge part of it. It gets really gruesome when you're splatting and tearing and screaming. I mean, you really are immersed in the battlefield. Like any new game, we did encounter a few issues. One with the queue system. We were unable to get a queue using the search button. We were forced to enter servers manually. When entering a server in a group, your allies must join manually to follow you in the same match. Other than that, we enjoyed the game here at the studio. Even if you're not a top tier player, it's still good for hours and hours of combat fun. We'll see you on the battlefield.